two main avenues, I would say. One is selected renal indication. We will focus our efforts into it. We have gained a lot of experience in the renal arena through the Fabry development. And the second one, we are looking for technologies, I would say high-end from an innovation point of view, to add or to combine with our ProCellEx platform and actually create, I would say, ProCellEx 3.0.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dror Bashan. He is the CEO of Protalix BioTherapeutics. And Dror, it's great to see you. How are you?
Thank you, Steve. I'm fine. Thank you for the time.
Yeah, good to hear from you and good to hear more about the company. Doing some really interesting things, helping, it seems like, quite a few people. And maybe just give us a bit of background on the company itself. You've been with the company, what, about 5 years now?
Yes, I'm 5.5 years in the company. You know, the company is way older, based on unique technology where we can express complex human proteins from full plant cells in suspension. We have two drugs approved. One is ELELYSO for Gaucher, and the second one, which was approved in May of 2023, called Elfabrio for Fabry disease. Elfabrio is labeled for adult Fabry patients in Fabry disease, of course. Commercial rights globally are with Chiesi, which is a private Italian company, I mean, located worldwide, of course. Headquarters is based in Boston, and they commercialize, you know, Elfabrio worldwide.
Yeah, Dror, maybe you could expand a bit on the technology itself and how it works and what sort of areas that you target with it.
So actually, the technology is where we use plant cells. Through the plant cells, we actually express the protein. It's complex human protein, meaning with glycosylation. Protalix actually was established in 1994 already. Speak about a 30-year-old company. Along the years, there were different, I would say, trials and errors and successes. So there were many scars, but two major successes. One is approval of an enzyme replacement therapy for Gaucher disease. And the second one is an enzyme replacement therapy plus a PEG for Fabry disease, as I mentioned. And there is a third one that is went into the clinic about a year ago, finalized successfully a phase one study for refractory gout. It's another pegylated enzyme, pegylated uricase, which is an enzyme for Gaucher disease. It's a unique technology. As far as I'm aware, the vast majority of the platforms that express complex human proteins are from mammalian cells, what is called CHO in slang. You know, it's unique. Yeah. It's competitive. We can do, and we plan to apply additional technologies and therapy through this system. So we are pleased.
Yeah, and in 2024, actually, you had news on PRX-115, which is for gout. You did a human trial, correct?
Yes, actually, in 2024, I think it was in November, we published top line results from the phase one study. It was a study with about 64 subjects with hyperuricemia. The outcomes were very much encouraging when we actually advised that we are moving into phase two, which we plan to initiate by the summer of this year or Q3 this year.
Okay. Let's talk about the company itself as far as the financials are concerned, because I know you've worked really hard in getting the company to a certain place it is right now, which is now debt-free. And that's a real positive for a company like yours, especially the size, right?
Yes, thank you. Indeed. Yeah. You know, the first few years were tough. We had a pretty big debt, I mean, considerably, of course, to our size. It was actually a debt in form of convertible bonds. Actually, along the years, the note holders or the debt holders indeed supported us, and still we paid something like $65 million in cash in the last 5 years. I mean, for a small company like us, it was significant, I would say. Yeah. And indeed today, as of September 1st, we paid the last $20 million piece of debt. We actually debt-free. We sit on, I won't say tons of cash, but on enough cash to maintain our operation and the phase two of gout, just to be clear. So I think we moved from, I would say, a more dangerous financial situation to a stable company, tuned to grow. We have three streams of revenues. One from Pfizer, one from Brazil, from ELELYSO. This is the ERT for Gaucher. And the second one, which is planned to grow dramatically in the next few years, I hope, and furthermore, is from Elfabrio, which is the drug for Fabry disease with Chiesi.
So 2025, let's talk about the year ahead. So the key will be obviously the phase two that you're working on, and then just continued growth from what you already have in the market. Is that, are you looking at other things as well for 2025, Dror?
So, yes and yes. The first one, we hope and we expect Chiesi to gradually grow their sales and their penetration worldwide. Actually, they're approved in most of the main markets and they continue to register the drug in additional markets. And they invest heavily in the medical plan, which means additional clinical studies to expand the franchise. This is one. Second, indeed, to initiate the phase two, which is a robust clinical study. And hopefully, the outcomes will be positive. The future will tell. And the third one, we have finalized actually in mid-2024 a long strategic or fine-tuning our strategy and pathway forward, including the R&D strategy. And we are moving into in the research mainly into two main avenues, I would say. One is selected renal indication. We will focus our efforts into it. We have gained a lot of experience in the renal arena through the Fabry development. And the second one, we are looking for technologies, I would say high-end from an innovation point of view, to add or to combine with our ProCellEx platform and actually create, I would say, ProCellEx 3.0. And the outcome supposed to be, and we try to stay very focused, our therapies that address real unmet needs, mainly within the renal area.
Well, it's an exciting year ahead for sure.
Yes.
Congratulations on being debt-free and having money in the balance sheet as well. It's quite a testament to the work that you and the team have done, Dror. So congratulations on that. Thanks very much for joining us. Really appreciate your time.
Okay, thank you very much.
All right, we look forward to following your story as well. Dror Bashan, he's the CEO of Protalix BioTherapeutics.